You know, it's when I'm with you, it's difficult to know where to start. Let's start just what drives you. What is it that when you wake up in the morning, do you see a problem and you want to solve it?
Fundamentally, the future is vastly more exciting and interesting if we're a space-faring civilization and a multi-planet species than if we're not. You want to be inspired by things. You want to wake up in the morning and think the future is going to be great. And that's what being a space-faring civilization is all about. It's about believing in the future and thinking that the future will be better than the past. And I can't think of anything more exciting than going out there and being among the stars. That's why. So becoming...
Then a space shuttle retired and the United States could take no one to orbit. So that's the trend. The trend is like down to nothing. This is not... People are mistaken when they think that technology just automatically improves. It does not automatically improve. It only improves if a lot of people work very hard to make it better. And actually, it will, I think, it by itself degrade, actually. You look at great civilizations like ancient Egypt, and they were able to make the pyramids, and they forgot how to do that. And the Romans, they built these incredible aqueducts. They forgot how to do it.
And they just work like hell. I mean, you just have to put in, you know, 80 to 100 hour weeks every week. And
then
all those things improve the odds of success.
You know, there are American heroes who don't like this idea. Neil Armstrong, Gene Cernan have both testified against commercial spaceflight and the way that you're developing it. And I wonder what you think of that.
I was very sad to see that because those guys are, you know, those guys are heroes of mine, so it's really tough. You know, I wish they would come and visit and see the hardware that we're doing here.
So that's what we've been practicing with Falcon 9. So this is just a series of landing bits. I think these are quite mesmerizing. But we now have 16 successful landings in a row. And that's with...
When critics say you can't do this, your answer to them is...
We've done it.
When you had that third failure in a row, did you think, I need to pack this in?
Never.
Why not?
I don't ever give up. I mean, I'd have to be dead or completely incapacitated.
Personally, I find gets me more excited is the fact that this would be an incredible adventure. I mean, it'd be like the greatest adventure ever. And it would be exciting and inspiring. And there need to be things that excite and inspire people.
Yeah.
You have to be, you know, reasons why you get up in the morning. You can't just be solving problems. It's got to be, something great's going to happen in the future.
Yeah, we talked about this at length yesterday. It's not an exit strategy or a backup plan
right.
for humankind.
No. Yeah, I think it's important to have a future that is inspiring and appealing. I mean, I just think that there have to be reasons that you get up in the morning and you want to live. Like, why do you want to live? What's the point? What inspires you? What do you love about the future? And if we're not out there, if the future does not include being out there among the stars and being a multi-planet species, I find that it's incredibly depressing if that's not the future that we're going to have.